Greetings everyone. We start our biology explanation from today. The first chapter that we will be doing is cell, the unit of life. The scope of the syllabus is we have to learn about all the different types of organelles present in the cell. It is mentioned over here. And we have to find out or study about the major differences between prokaryotic and eukaryotic cell. What these are, we'll be talking about it. We also will study about the difference between plant cell and animal cell. Now, as I have told you in previous classes in earlier year, that whenever we study differences with which or with what respect we are studying it, that is very important. So, difference between plant cell and animal cell will be discussed in this chapter with respect to the cell wall, centrosome, vacuoles and plastids. So, while writing the answers also, be very particular about it. Okay, so this chapter, as I've given you a PDF format, the first few things about is microscope and all, I'm not going to delve into it. What I want to tell you about is cell. What is a cell? We all know that if in the exam this question arises that what is a cell, the thing that we have to write is it is the fundamental, structural and functional unit of all living beings. Now, there are these three words which are very important. One is fundamental, one is structural, one is functional. Fundamental means that the building block, that this is the fundamental being, or this is the building block of living organisms. No matter what kind of a living organism it is, without a cell, it is not possible. Structural means it is the structure of the cell that decides the structure of a particular microorganism or a particular organ or a particular living organism, no matter what it is. And also how the cell functions. The function of the cell also has a huge impact on the functioning of the living organism. So that's about cell and why it is known as the fundamental, structural and functional unit of all living beings. We know that cells can be microscopic as well as huge. Huge as in eggs. So, they can be magnified with the help of microorganisms. I'm not going to delve deeper into this. I'm straight away coming to a cell theory, which you have learned a little about in the previous classes. Well, cell theory was devised by three scientists. In 1838, Matthias Schleiden, a German botanist, announced one part of it, that every plant is made up of a large number of cells. To this theory, he added that each of the cells perform various life processes. That first of all, they are made up of various cells, and all the life processes like respiration, excretion, reproduction, each cell performs one such life process. A year later, in 1839, Theodor Schwann, he was a German zoologist, he made similar discoveries in animals. So first it was discovered in plants, then it was discovered in animals. He declared that all animals and plants are composed of cells. Obviously, he borrowed a part of the theory from Matthias Schleiden and said that they also serve as the units of structure and function. This, in short, was called the cell theory. Now, Rudolf Virchow, in 1858, finally made the latest addition to the cell theory by saying that all cells arise from pre-existing cells. Okay, so when you are asked to write cell theory in exam, this is what you are going to write, this yellow box. The cell theory states three major points. The cell is the smallest unit of structure of all living things. Second point, cell is the unit of function of all living things. The third point, all cells arise from pre-existing cells. Very simple. But if the question comes where you have to explain each of these points, then we move on to this part. So what does the cell theory mean? Like structural unit, if we take any part of the body of a frog or part of a mango plant and examine, it will show a cellular structure. This tells us that no matter what organism we are observing, at a microscopic level, at the basic level, there has to be a cell. And it is the structure of the cell that shapes the organism. The way you people look, the way our skin looks, the way our stomach looks, the way our hair looks, or the way a mango leaf looks, it is due to the structure of the cell present in it. Okay? Next, we come to the functional unit. It says in the book that any function in the body of the frog or in the mango plant is due to the activity in itself. For example, here very good examples are given. Movement of frog is due to the contraction of the muscles. Food digested is by the enzymes which is secreted by the cells. You know, the fact that you can run, you can play football, you can dance, because your muscles cells, which help in all these movements, can stretch or can contract, can move. That's why you can move. The fact that you can digest all the good food that you eat, and obviously the ones that you don't want to eat, you can digest it because the cells present in your stomach, in your intestine, in your mouth, they secrete certain enzymes. If they would not have done those functions, then your body would not have been able to digest the food. That means the function of your body depends on the function of the cell. That's why functional unit. That's why they are known as functional unit. Cells die and are replaced. Yes. We now, in whichever state we are, we do not have the cells that we were born with. All the cells that we were born with have died and they are replaced by new cells. Cells also have a lifetime. They die and they are replaced by new young ones. Okay, so this formation of cells from pre-existing cells, this is what happens. The last point, all cells arise from pre-existing cells, that has been explained here, that one cell divides into two cells. Two cells divide into four cells. Now, the cells which were previously there, they keep dying. The new cells, they keep forming. This is a never-ending chain. It keeps on happening. One more point has been added here in explaining the cell theory, that all life starts as a single cell. Yes. If we consider multicellular organisms, all life starts when embryo is formed or when zygote is formed. Okay. So here it is said, the life of the frog and the life of the mango tree started as a fertilized egg, which we call a zygote, and as a seed respectively. Okay, the egg was a single cell produced by the cells of the ovary, and the mango seed had an embryo. The mango seed had an embryo within it, which gave rise to an entire mango tree. And similarly, the fertilized egg or zygote gave rise to the frog. So this is about cell theory. Hope it is clear to you all. The next content would be about, it will be an external link about plant cell. There will be two video links of plant cells sent to you. So first, I hope this is clear to you. Then you go through the plant cell videos. Once you go through the plant cell videos, then I will explain each of the organelles separately. Thank you guys.